Welcome back to STS. In this video we're going to continue with the difference quotient, this time working with a reciprocal function, and we're going to find the slope and the equation of the tangent line for this reciprocal function at the x value of 3, and our reciprocal function is 9 over x. We begin by figuring out what the value of y is, and that's done by just doing a basic substitution. Here the value of x is a 3, so we substitute that in. We end up with 9/3, which turns out to be a 3. So here we can say that y equals 3, and we also know that our point of tangency is at 3, 3. From here we're going to work on the difference quotient, or the derivative. So that's found as f prime of x is equal to the limit as h approaches 0 of the function f, where the input is x plus h, minus the original function, where all of that is divided by the value of h. Alright, and our next line, as we continue, we're going to take the independent variable x plus h, and we're going to substitute that into the original function. So everywhere where there's an x, we're going to put in an x plus h minus the original function, which is 9 over x, and we write our denominator, which is h. Alright, at this point we have a complex fraction, and with this complex fraction we need a common denominator in our numerator, and that common denominator is x times x plus h. As we look at the fraction on the left hand side, it's missing an x, so we multiply our denominator by x, which we've already done, and then the numerator by x to give us 9x minus, and let me do the second fraction on the right hand side, and again that denominator is the same, x times the quantity x plus h. We notice this right hand fraction is missing x plus h, so we're going to multiply the 9 times x plus h, and this entire complex fraction is now divided by h. Let's continue here at the top. Again, the limit as h approaches 0. We can take this complex numerator and write that so it's over one denominator. So here we have 9x minus, and I'm going to distribute this negative 9 to both of these terms, so that's going to end up being a negative 9x minus a 9h, and the denominator here is going to stay as x times x plus h, and then the entire denominator for this complex fraction is an h. At this point I need to do some simplification. Here in the numerator I see I have a positive 9x minus 9x, so those go away, and I'm left with a negative 9h over x times x plus h, and then times this h here is really h over 1, so when I'm dividing I end up multiplying by the reciprocal, so I end up multiplying by 1 over h. Alright, at this point I'm left with the limit as h approaches 0. These h's here cancel, so I have negative 9 over x times the quantity x plus h, and just negative 9 times the 1 remains negative 9, and again this quantity times the 1 that's left over gives me that quantity there, and now I'm at the position where I can substitute in the value of 0 for h. So I have negative 9 over x times x plus 0, which turns into negative 9 over x squared. Now what I need to do is find out what the exact value, this here is the expression for the slope, let's find out what the exact value of the slope is at the point where x is 3. So f prime of x, well not of x, but actually f prime of 4, because I'm sorry, not 4, but 3. F prime of 3, and I'm going to substitute this 3 into this expression here. So negative 9 over 3 squared, which gives me negative 9 over 9, which gives me a value of negative 1 as the slope. Now I need to figure out the equation for this tangent line. All right, I fall back to the slope intercept form, and again let's change color, let's go back to the blue. Slope intercept form is y is equal to mx plus b. I know the y value to be 3 because that's what I found from my point of tangency. We just found the slope to be negative 1, that there's m. We know that the x value, which is given, is 3, and we're trying to figure out what that y-intercept is. So we have 3 is equal to negative 1 times 3 to give me a negative 3. And then I'm adding the b. Then I need to isolate the b, so I add 3 to both sides. Those 3's cancel, so I have 6 is equal to b. Now I can write the equation for the tangent line. Y is equal to the slope, which is negative 1 times x, or just negative x, plus 6. All right, so here we found the value of y when the x value is 3. We found the point of tangency, we found the slope at this value of x, and we found the tangent line. And now let's take a look at the calculator to verify these results. First, let's go to y equals. And in y equals, you'll see that I've already input the original equation, 9 over x, and I've input the tangent line, which is y equals negative x plus 6. Let's go to zoom, and let's set it at 6 for standard so we can take a look at what this function looks like. All right, the blue is the original function, and the red is the tangent line. And notice I put a box here. This box is at the point of tangency, which is 3, 3. Let's go ahead and zoom in. Everything is happening in this first quadrant. So let's take a look at the first quadrant. We press zoom, and then we want to go down to the option where it says quadrant 1. All right, and that there is option A. So we press enter. All right, we get a better look at quadrant 1, but notice we have all these positive values of y that we don't really need. Let's set our maximum y value to be 6 to kind of give us an even closer look. So we click on window. We go down to y max. We change that from 13 and 2 tenths to a value of 6. And then we press graph. And now we get a pretty good picture of the blue, the original function, the red, the tangent line, and the box, the point of tangency. All right, at this point, let's go ahead and also take a look at what the slope is at that particular point. So let's do that by pressing the second key and then trace. And we want to go down to option 6, which is the derivative. All right, and we said in this problem that we want to know the value of the derivative when x is 3. Right now x is at 6.6. Let's move it over so we can get our x value back at 3. All right, also notice that when x is 3, the y is 3, which we found by hand as our point of tangency. Now when I click enter, we see that the derivative is negative 1, just like we showed here by hand. All right, that sums it up for this video by Speller Tutorial Services. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel, and thank you again for watching.